right, ladies and gentlemen, we are ready to get back to the action here.
Number one, Dangerous Kurt is jamming for the Auburn Outlaws.
And that's number 48, Pinky Z, jamming for Westside Records. Auburn doing their best to try to contain Pinky, but she is out of the back. Trying to catch up with that Auburn jammer.
And Kirk calls it off.
0 points for each team on that jam.
Number 411, Diabolical is jamming for the Outlaws.
And that's number 30 out of 6, Ammunition, jamming for Westside. Westside?
Both jammers still in the pack.
And Auburn defense doing their best to contain Ammunition.
Diabolical is your lead jammer from the Auburn Outlaws.
Ammunition getting recycled to the back. Going to keep up here, try to complete her initial pass. Number 21, Pandemonium, doing a great job of containing the Wreckers jammer. He is finally out. Number 12. Ladies and gentlemen, don't forget the Sierra Sparks Junior Roller Derby are having a bake sale and a merchandise blowout near the front entrance. They're also raffling off a handmade quilt, only $1 per ticket. On the line for the Westside Wreckers, number 32, Minnie Pearl.
And for the Auburn Outlaws, we have number 33, Princess Rage, jamming. Recycled back.
Minnie Pearl's out front. She is your lead jammer. We're going to pick up some points for the Wreckers here on her first scoring pass. And there's Minnie Pearl picking up 5 big points for the Wreckers.
Number 3, Smallosaurus in the box for the Outlaws. And she is joined by their captain, number 2B, Smashlin.
That's Minnie Pearl picking up 5 more points for the Westside, calling off the jam. Any Westside fans in the house? Westside? On the line for Westside now, it's number 12, Shock Hazard.
Number 742, Pizzazz is jamming for the Auburn Outlaws.
Chuck Hazard looking to make her way to the outside. That's number 22. Blah Blah Red will give her some trouble up front, but Chuck Hazard is your lead jammer.
Pizzazz is still in the pack.
That's number 16, Ounce Long Legs, trying to contain that Wrecker jammer, but she cannot. Chuck Hazard putting up 5 more points for Westside.
And the Auburn
Cats are trying to skate through on the inside.
Number 22, Passion Swivel Hips, is now the Auburn Outlaws Jammer.
Shot Cats playing some defense, picking up 3 points for the Westside Wreckers.
Number one, Dangerous Curves, is jamming for the Auburn Outlaws.
And that's number 30 out of 6, Ammunition, taking the star for the Wreckers. Great defense in the back there from number 21, Pandemonium. Oh, looks like Ammunition is going to the penalty box for an elbow.
And it is a power jam. Dangerous Curves making her way around the track.
That's number 4, Nightmare, trying to do some pack work up front. And to contain that Auburn Jammer.
Dangerous Curves speeding up that pack. She's going through it, breaking up those blockers and scoring 5 more points. And Curves calls it off.
Ammunition leaving the box there, but not enough time to do any damage.
The Auburn Outlaws have 21, and the Westside Wreckers have 18.
On the jammer line for Westside, number 32, Minnie Pearl.
411, Diabolical is jamming for the Auburn Outlaws.
Minnie Pearl making her way through the pack. Got a few more blockers to get past. And she does. She's your lead jammer.
Diabolical making her way out of the pack.
Minnie Pearl, number 32, picking up a cut call, and that spells power jam for Auburn.
Number 411, Diabolical, is headed to the box as well. Both jammers in the box.
All right, we got a little jammer swap there, and then we're back to the action.
Although she didn't spend any time in the box, Diabolical did lose her lead jammer status, and this will be a full 2-minute jam.
Minnie Pearl trying to figure out what's going on. She's found her way to the back of the Auburn pack. Meanwhile, that's number 411, Diabolical. Diabolical scoring unabated. Diabolical through with another grand slam. Meanwhile, Minnie Pearl getting the business at the back of the pack. Not able to avoid picking up another cut for Westside.
Diabolical grabs 4 more points before the jam time elapsed.
And Westside not able to score on that jam.
The Auburn Outlaws have 42, and the Westside Wreckers have 18.
All right. Auburn is going to have a power start here. The jam is underway.
Number 22, Passion Swivel Hips, is your lead jammer from the Auburn Outlaws. Power Jam. Number 25, Bam Bam Billings, is now serving a penalty for the Auburn Outlaws.
And Minnie Pearl ready to find her way through the back here and try to complete her initial pass. And she does.
Passion grabs four more points before calling it off.
0 points for Westside on that jam. But that's the good thing about roller derby. When one jam ends, there's always another.
Number 33, Princess Race, will be jamming.
Taking the star for Westside, it's number 48, Pinky Z. Oh, that's number 1602. Long legs, picking up a low block, headed to the penalty box.
Ironically, because she tripped someone with her long leg.
That's a good one. Meanwhile, back in the pack, that's number 48, Pinky Z, jamming for Westside, trying to make her way to the front. Actually, in fact, forget that, she's lead jammer.
Number 33, Princess Rach, struggling in the pack.
Pinky Z making her way to the front, and she has completed her initial pass. Pinky Z threading her way through the Auburn blockers, picking up five more points for Westside.
Number 33, Princess Rage, has made her way out of the pack.
Oh! You see, picking up a big hit and then deciding to call it off. She does pick up one more point for Westside on the end of that jam.
Updated score, Auburn Outlaws have 51 and the Westside Wreckers have 24.
Ladies and gentlemen, don't forget the raffle. It wouldn't be a derby tournament without a raffle. We've got a wonderful Day of the Dead basket valued at $300. Includes some Grateful Dead memorabilia, one night stay at the Jamestown Hotel, and a bunch of other cool stuff. Taking the star for Westside, it's number 30-06, Ammunition.
And for the Auburn Outlaws, jamming is 7422, Pizzazz.
Ammunition getting recycled to the back, and that allows the Auburn Jammer to become lead.
Pizzazz is your lead jammer.
Number 32, Minnie Pearl, and number 328, Bushy Riot, headed to the penalty box for Westside. Ammunition trying to get through there, but she does not. The Auburn Jammer very wisely calling it off. All right, ladies and gentlemen, looks like a two-on-two pack situation here for the teams. And that is number 1-2, Shock Hazard, jamming for the Westside Wreckers.
And number 1, Dangerous Curve. Number 1, Dangerous Curve, is your lead jammer.
Number 3, Smallosaurus, doing a great job of containing the record jammer. She does eventually make it through.
Dangerous Curve almost sneaks her way completely through the pack, but you can still get all 4 points. Kirk stays on her skates and picks up another 5 points.
Jock Hazard making her way through on her initial scoring pass, picking up 4 points for the West Side Wreckers. Oh! That West Side defense trying to stop the Auburn jammer. She does call off the jam.
My life, we're all full of lies.
Taking the track for Auburn, number 8, Allie Sylum.
Jamming for the Auburn Outlaws is number 411, Dio Brolico.
And on the jammer line for West Side, number 32, Minnie Pearl. Like number 32, Mini Pro is going off the track.
Dio Brolico is your lead jammer. And she has a power jam. Number 32, Mini Pro, serving her penalty.
Dio Brolico making her way through the pack, picking up 5 more points for the Auburn Outlaws. And it appears number 32 for West Side Wreckers, Minnie Pearl, has fouled out of the game. Meanwhile, back on the track,
Dio Brolico picking up 5 more points.
West Side just having to try to contain the scoring here. Pinky Z stretching the engagement zone, trying to stop the Auburn jammer, but she can't hold her for long. Auburn definitely going to try to work this power jam to its full length.
And she calls it off.
It looks like we have a timeout for Westside. That gives us an opportunity to talk about more raffle stuff. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Don't forget, buy your raffle tickets. They are $3 each, two for $5, and four for $10. Why don't you tell us about that Marilyn Monroe raffle basket there?
In the Marilyn Monroe raffle basket, valued at $250, we have a Marilyn Monroe bottle of wine and knife collection, a mouth guarding case, Rideout tough toe skate protection.
A knife collection. I didn't know Marilyn was into knives.
You learn something new every day. Also, you have t-shirts, necklaces, earrings, bearings, and much more.
Also included in that Marilyn Monroe basket with the knife collection is a $60 gift certificate for tattoo from Westside Inc. I bet they could even get a Marilyn tattoo if they wanted to.
It would be fitting.
All right, well, we have a minute here, ladies and gentlemen. I want to send a shout out to our incredible volunteers here at Attack of the Sea Squads, all the people that put on the show here at the venue, all of our officials, both skating and non-skating. If you see someone doing a volunteer job, give them a high five, give them a smile. They are working very hard to put on this incredible tournament for everybody. I got to the bottom of me. That life is still for me. Sound, we are back to the action, ladies and gentlemen. On the line for the Westside Wreckers, it's number 30-06, Ammunition.
And for the Auburn Outlaws, we have number 22, Passion Swivelhead.
Please don't make that sound again. Trying to make her way through the back there.
And number 22, Passion Swivelhead, is your lead jammer.
Taking a turn in the penalty box, it's number 1602, Long Legs. And I'm going to spend some time with her, that's number 5446, Two Pints of Bruise. Ammunition able to pick up four more points for the Westside Wreckers. Want to give a special shout out to the High Country Mountain Derby Girls, the host, the perpetual host of Attack of the Sea Squads here in Sonora, California. Such a good time, everybody. We're glad you're here. On the line for the Westside Wreckers, that's number 48, Pinky Z. Uh-oh. Figured out? No, we don't. Things still are perplexing us. All right. And as number 1-2, Shock Hazard takes her place in the penalty box, we are ready to get back underway.
Both teams having two blockers, or two and three blockers in the box, actually. Number 722, Pizzazz. Auburn Outlaws.
And number 48, Pinky Z is out front. She is your lead jammer for the West Side Wreckers.
Pizzazz is out of the pack.
And with some gentle coaxing from her bench, Pinky C does call off the jam, but not before picking up 4 points for West Side.
Jamming next for the Auburn Outlaws is number 1, Dangerous Curve.
And taking the star for West Side is number 36,
Ammunition. I have a problem with this one, if the results are the same. Let's see the medicine. Yes, the medicine. Let's go.
Ammunition making her way through the Auburn pack, picking up lead jammer for West Side.
Number 1, Dangerous Curve, trying to make up some ground. Dangerous Curve managed to grab 2 points before the Wreckers called off the jam.
And it looks like West Side picked up another 4 points. Want to give a special shout out to DJ iPod. DJ iPod, ladies and gentlemen, doing a great job all day long. Never needs a break.
Updated score, the Auburn Outlaws have 99 and the West Side Wreckers have 40.
Back on the line for West Side, number 48, Pinky Z. She's out front and she is your lead jammer.
Number 411, Diabolical, is the jammer for the Auburn Outlaws.
Pinky Z getting her way through the pack. Not able to pick up any points for West Side, but very strategically able to call off the jam and prevent the Auburn jammer from scoring. Back on the line for West Side, once again, number 48, Pinky Z. Pinky Z, not to be denied. Through the pack on the outside, she is your lead jammer.
Number 7422, Pizzazz, approaching the pack.
Excellent job by West Side there, scooting through on the inside, picking up 3 points and calling off the jam.
The Auburn Outlaws were not able to score any points on that last pass.
Ladies and gentlemen, we know you love cupcakes, we know you love baked goods, and we know you love Junior Derby. So please, please, please patronize the Sierra Sparks Junior Roller Derby Bake Sale. It's right here in the building. We're also having a merchandise blowout. Right over there by the front door. You can't miss them. They're the little derby skaters with the baked goods.
Number 1, Dangerous Curve is going to be jamming for the Auburn Outlaws.
And once again on the line for the West Side Wreckers, it's 30-06, Ammunition. We get a thumbs up from the NSO. That tells us everything is good to go. And that sound means we are ready to get back to the action. Looks like number 1, Dangerous Curves, saying, don't stop me now. She's out front. She is your lead jammer. Meanwhile, number 1-2, Shotcaster taking a turn in the penalty box.
Number 30-06, Mission will be heading to the box for a cut, which means that Dangerous Curve does have a power jam.
Dangerous Curve is able to pick up 5 more points for Auburn on that pass.
And Dangerous Curve calls it off. Westside Records Jammer still in the box at the beginning of this jam. Which means that number 411, Diabolical, will start this jam with a power jam.
Three pack advantage for Westside, hoping to flex a little penalty kill here, but they cannot. And number 411, Diabolical, she's out front. She is your lead jammer.
Both jammers on the track now. Another pass.
Number 3, Smallosaurus, headed to the box for a forearm.
Ammunition has now made her initial pass.
And Diabolical and the Westside Wreckers stretching the definition of a pack. She is through and picks up 4 more points for Auburn.
Ammunition is headed back to the penalty box.
And just like that, number 411, Diabolical has picked up 5 more points for the Auburn Outlaw.
Diabolical gaining 5 more points for the Auburn Outlaws.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you're an Auburn Outlaw fan in the house, Diabolical just scored 29 points on that jam. There you go. When somebody scores 29 points, you make some noise.
And we have a timeout right now, folks. Number 2B, Mashlin, the Auburn Outlaws captain, will be jamming for them.
And taking the star for the Westside Wreckers with the pink skates, it's number 48, Pinky Z. Pack advantage for Auburn. Let's see if they can use that to their benefit. Number 2B, Smashlin, making her way on the outside, picking up lead jammer for the Outlaws.
Pinky Z making her way out of the pack.
Smashlin working it side to side, and she picks up 4 more points for Auburn. Thank you. That's a tenacious hit on the outside by number 766, Tenacious. That must be how she got that name. Uh-oh.
Number 2B, Smashlin, is headed to the box.
Pinky Z hoping to take advantage here. You see, working hard to get through that Auburn pack. She does, and she picks up 5 more points for the West Side Records.
Number 2B, Smashlin, the Auburn Outlaws captain, has fouled out of the game.
Meanwhile, back on the track, Pinky Z doing her best to get past the Auburn defenders. Number 82, Pity the Fool. Blocking Pinky to the outside. Causing her to go back to the pack. Pinky does pick up 1 point on that jam. Sorry. Correction, Pinky picking up 4 points for the West Side Records.
With 50 seconds left, folks, the score is 147 Auburn Outlaws and 58 West Side Records.
Westside taking the time out here. And that timeout will give us a chance to say thank you once again to the High Country Mountain Derby girls.
That's a mouthful.
We're putting on this wonderful tournament that you're all attending. Attack of the Sea Squads, the 3rd. Any way you want it, that's the way you need it, and whatever you want, you can get it at the snack bar.
I knew you were going to say the snack bar. I knew that's where you were going.
Ah, see? Chemistry right here. They have pretzels, they have hot dogs, they have churros, they have a wide variety of sugar of all different colors and flavors for you to put in your body.
Number 7422, Pizzazz, jamming for the Auburn Outlaws.
And taking the star for Westside, it's 30-06, Ammunition.
Number 3006, Ammunition, is your lead jammer from the West Side Records. Pizzazz is still in the pack. And she's out.
Ammunition making her way through the pack, picking up some points here for Westside. That's number 8, Allie Silent at the front of the pack, knocking her to the inside.
5 more seconds left on this period clock, folks.
Ammunition clears the engagement zone. And Bookslinger puts up 4 fingers. That means 4 points for the West Side Records.
Pizzazz still in the pack.
Ammunition not satisfied with her point total. She wants to pick up some more points for Westside, and she does. Looks like she's picked up 5 points on that pass.
45 more seconds left on the jam clock.
Ammunition taking advantage of some looky-loo in the pack. Skates her way through, picking up 5 more points for Westside.
10 more seconds in this game.
ammunition, signaling some instructions to her teammates.